Hello friends, I'm Dr. Kamal Talat, Professor of English. I'm posted at Government VYT, PG Autonomous College, Durg. This college, it comes under the jurisdiction of Hemchand Yadav University. I will be discussing paper 3, that is prose of second semester. And my lecture of today will be on Robert Lind's most famous essay, The Pleasures of Ignorance. Robert Lind started his career as a professional journalist and contributed essays to New Statesman under the pseudonym YY. Later, he became literary editor of the News Chronicle. His well-known books of essays are Portraits and Impressions, The Book of This and That, The Pleasures of Ignorance, I Tremble to Think, and It's a Fine World. Now here I am going to discuss his most famous essay, The Pleasures of Ignorance. In this essay, Robert Lind has described the pleasures that one gets from ignorance. He feels that it is a matter of great pleasure to discover new things and ask new questions, for not knowing a thing makes a man very happy. He strongly supports the case of ignorance or the pleasure that is derived from ignorance. The essay focuses on our knowledge is never complete. Lind feels that while walking in a countryside, one comes to realize that he is very ignorant, because quite a good number of people are never able to find out the difference between a beech and an elm. Similarly, people are not able to differentiate between the song of a thrush and that of a blackbird. Lind feels that the pleasure that a scholar gets after acquiring new knowledge is also due to his ignorance. Since he does not know about that thing, and when he comes to know it, he feels very happy. Common people alone are not ignorant. Ignorance is even found in great scholars. In order to prove it, the author gives the illustration of the cuckoo. It is not only an individual, but several others who does not have much information about the bird. He felt that ignorance was not only his weakness, but it is true of so many people. That is why Lind says that ignorance is not confined to cuckoo alone. It may be of several things.